Hello guys, today I'm going to show you how to homebrew your Wii U and your virtual Wii. First download and unzip the folder from the link in the video description. Also make sure that your SD card is formatted in FAT32. In this picture you can see where to put which file if you want to install homebrews or games by yourself. Now put the files from the folder SD card on your SD card. I'm going to show you how to use Homebrew with a Wii U browser, but I recommend to use the HackMii method, because it's more stable and you can use it while being offline. But you need to own an original copy of a Virtual Console DS game. You will find my video for that tutorial and the German versions I made for each video in the description. If you only want to continue with the tutorial and don't want to see how to use these homebrews, you can use the timestamps. Now take your SD card out of your computer and put it in your Wii U. Open the browser and go to u.vdb.de, or if your Wii U firmware version is below 5.5.1, go to login.ovh. You can find both links in the description. Now click on the link that says Hacks. Now just open the Homebrew App Store after we got into the Homebrew Launcher menu. Here you can download homebrews right from your Wii U. Now go back to the Homebrew Launcher by pressing minus. If you want to create a digital copy of your Wii U game, just open Disk to App. Now press A after you made sure that you have at least 23.3 GB of free storage on your SD card, and after it's set so, you can insert your game disk. I'm going to use Splatoon because it's a relatively small game. It only took around 8 minutes to finish. After it's finished, it will automatically kick you back to the Homebrew Launcher menu. Now I will show you how to connect other gamepads to your Wii U. First, open Hit2 VPAD, and if you want to use them wirelessly, you need to open on your PC Hit2 VPAD Network Client, which you can find in the PC Tools folder. Connect your controller with your PC and type in your IP address, which you can find in the upper right corner of your Wii U gamepad, and click on Connect. Now just click on the screen on No Device and press any button on your controller. If you press a button on the controller, the gamepad should show you this input on a controller model. To disconnect, simply click at disconnect on your PC and press on your gamepad the home button to get back to the Homebrew Launcher. With SwapDRC, you can swap the screen of your TV and your gamepad screen in order to play games on your gamepad only. With SigPatcher, you can make SigPatches in order to use channels which needs them. And now we are going to open WUP Installer GX2. After the installer is opened, press on your gamepad minus to select all channels, or press just on the channels or games you want to install, and then press install. When the installation process is finished, you will get kicked back to the Wii U home menu. Now that we are back in the Wii U menu, you can see that Splatoon is there now two times. One time as a disc version and the second time as a channel version. To continue with the tutorial, we are going back to the Homebrew Launcher. When you're back at the Homebrew Launcher, first open NAND-Dumper to create a backup. You can skip the backup, but in the case that your virtual Wii breaks, you need to have a backup of SLCC, MPT and OTP. Select everything you want to backup and then press A. After it's finished, it will close automatically and you will end up at the Homebrew Launcher menu again. After that, we're going to open Wuphax. When you're in Wuphax, press A to backup the Mii channel and inject Wuphax. After the installation process is complete, go back to the Wii U menu and start your virtual Wii. To install Homebrew, we are going to open the Mii channel. Don't be surprised if it looks like nothing happens, it could take around 30 seconds until you can continue. When it says so, press 1 on your Wii mode. Then go on continue and after that install the Homebrew channel. When it has finished, exit the HackMii installer. Before we're going to install the rest, close the Homebrew channel and open the Homebrew launcher again. now that we are back at the Homebrew Launcher, we will reopen Wuphax to restore the Mii channel. To do that, simply press B instead of A this time, and after that, open the virtual Wii again. Now open the Homebrew channel. First, we are going to install some patched iOS. With that said, we will install the iOS 236 first. Simply open its installer and wait some time. Then, press any button to continue and wait again. And at the end, press any button again to exit the installer. Notice that if you install iOS on your virtual Wii, don't ever use iOS or custom iOS, which are meant for the original Wii, or the other way around. The same goes for WATS. Next, we're going to open the D2X cIOS installer. First, it will prepare everything, and when the credits and disclaimer show up, you can continue by pressing any button again. We are going to install the version 10 beta 52 and then we're going to go through the same process 3 times. I highlighted the base and slot you need to install. The first base is 56 and the slot is 249. Press A to install. After everything is complete, press B to exit. The iOS 80 is the last one we're going to modify. First, open its installer. A disclaimer will show up because this will modify a critical iOS, which means there is a small chance that it could break your vWii. Now, if you want to modify this iOS, just wait the 30 seconds and it will get installed all by itself. As always, press any button to exit the installer. First, we're going to install the channels. To do that, we're going to open some yet another WAT Manager mod modification. As source device, select the Wii SD slot and continue by pressing A. Now, mark every WAT you want to install with plus. The last two WATs will each install a channel for Savegame Manager GX, so choose only one. We install them by pressing A and when it asks if we want to proceed, we press A again. Press any button to continue. To get back to the Homebrew channel, we will first press B twice and then the Home button. To install the WiiFlow channel, we are going to open its installer. Just select Install Channels and after that, quit the channel. First, let's move back to the system menu. As you can see, we have now two Homebrew channels. The one in the upper right corner is the old channel. You can move it by pressing A and B on your Wiimote, but the new channel won't work if you delete the old one. First, let's set up the Savegame Manager GX. This Homebrew is used to backup game data and Mii files. Now we are going to set up our preferred language. You can find that option in the graphical user interface settings. The folder with the languages is in the Backup Manager GX folder. If the language resets after a console reboot, you can fix this problem by deleting the other language files. Next, I will show you how to change the look of the Homebrew. But every time you change the theme of the Savegame Manager GX, the console will crash, so I recommend to change it after the tutorial. I'll change it anyway, that you know how it works and what the theme looks like. Now, after we set up this Homebrew, we are going to back up a Wii game and set up the next Homebrew. The next Homebrew is a USB Loader GX. While it's booting, you can plug in your hard disk in the back USB port. The power only cable needs to connect to the top port, just like on this picture. First, we head over to graphical user interface and change the language. Here again, if the language causes any problem, just delete the not used files. Some other changes I would make is the keyboard layout and the disk and box cover layout. I would change them to original and community and to high and low. The next settings we are going to optimize are the loader settings and the hard drive options, which are a lot more important than the GUI settings. First, we go to private servers and choose WiiFlow. We need that in order to be able to play online. Also, make sure that Nintendo is selected for the GameCube mode. At the top, you can change in which file system you want to save your games. And if you don't like the default settings, you can change the way how the game folders are going to get named. In this homebrew, you can change the themes too, and you can change them without crashing your console. Just select them in the theme menu, and there are lots of custom themes for this homebrew. If you want to backup a game, you have to go to the plus, and after you made sure that the inserted game is the right one, just select OK. During the process, you can see the operating speed and the rest time. To be able to play your game, we open the index tab right next to the ABC tab and select everything. To download the images of the channels, we click on the empty Wii game cover and select OK. It will appear a window that asks if we want to install all the images which got found, and we click on Yes. The last homebrew I will show you is WiiFlow. Like the USB loader GX, it is a game loader. There are no differences in how they perform. Which one you want to use is just because of personal preferences. First, we need to select where the games are stored. Go over to Partitions and select Wii Partitions USB 2. On the second page, you can change the language, cover flow, that is how the game covers are presented, and the scenes. To change them, just go through the scenes you have installed and close the settings. To install the covers here too, just go to the settings and click on Start and Download. Like you can see now, it will show your game multiple times when you don't have that much. To close WiiFlow, simply press the home button and head over to Back to and choose where you want to go. So, that's all I have for you today. If you do have any questions or want to leave some feedback, please put them in the comments below. Also, if I could help you with this video, please like, share and subscribe. Check out the video description for the homebrews and their developers. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.